far. God, we want to thank you for the opportunity to gather at this program. We want to pray and commit all that to be done in this program. God, we pray that the
it is my singular honor. So it's a flag of all the distribution of medical equipment. And the last, any onlooker or reach them. I think that is something that we need to applaud. And it is in that stride that today we will reach to give you all the details. But I think I'll have the singular honor at the general remark of welcome. Please, may I invite Mrs. Sarah.
On behalf of the board, management and staff of the Plateau State Universal Basic Education Board, I feel highly honored and elated to welcome the transformer of education by excellence on the Plateau, Dr. Jonah David Jam, to this historic occasion, marking the flag off of the distribution of medical equipment to primary health care centers and instructional materials to public primary schools in Plateau State. Sir, the board deeply appreciates your commitment to turning around the education sector, especially at the foundational level. Your commitment is unparalleled in the history of Plateau State, and we are proud for the opportunity given to us to share in your vision and to implement same. I would like to inform you, sir, that at SUBEP, you have a crop of very dedicated officers and staff who work day and night with little supervision to ensure the educational agenda of this administration is achieved. We wish to recall, sir, that at the inception of this government, an emergency was declared in the education sector, which was almost comatose. This led to the payment of the backlog of counterpart funds to enable the state drawdown from the UBE consolidated funds at the national level, the stabilization of the payment of teacher salaries, the payment of the backlog of LEAP grants to create a conducive atmosphere for the implementation of the state of emergency declared on the sector and the agenda on education. We would like to seize this opportunity to inform you, sir, that the board has been able to do a lot of things which range from upgrading the facilities at SUBEP headquarters, which saw the procurement of standby generator, computers, laptops, digital cameras, borehole, purchase of vehicles, photocopiers, etc. We have also been involved in strengthening the skills of staff through professional and in-house trainings. We have also stepped up school supervision, inspection and monitoring. Permit me to inform you, sir, that the board has just received a letter of commendation from UBEC in this regard. We have also been involved in strengthening the capacity of the local education authorities through recruitment of educationists to serve as education secretaries, training of LGEA staff, restructuring of the LGEA, close monitoring of their activities to curb excesses and stem the culture of arbitrariness, wastages, and leakages of all kinds, thereby saving government hundreds of millions of naira. We have also embarked on promotion of community involvement in school development through the setting up of school-based management committees and self-help projects. We have also been engaged in first sighting of projects with priority given to difficult to reach areas. This, sir, has endeared your administration to many local communities and debunked the notion that you have to know someone in government before projects are located in your community. Sir, there is a community leader who is anxiously waiting for when you will commission the school in his community. He is overwhelmed by the transformation and says he has something to tell you. We do not know what it is, but he says he has something to tell you. We have also carried out renovation of 175 schools across the state. Over 85% of the work has been completed. For the remaining 15% yet to complete, the board has set up a machinery to assess and advise on revocation. So far, we have also trained over 19,000 teachers, on preparations of lesson notes, classroom management, continuous assessment, record keeping, implementation of the 9-year basic education curriculum, teaching of mathematics and English, etc. This is in addition to other trainings on the 4 core subjects sponsored by the Mdgs from 2007 to 2010. We have also strengthened special education to give a sense of belonging to children with different challenges. We have appointed a desk officer, procured relevant textbooks, teaching aids, and wheelchairs for those in need. And recently, we conducted a training on inclusive classrooms for primary school teachers in collaboration with some experts from the United States. We have also since commenced the implementation of the teacher salary structure. The Governor, sir, we are gathered here today to witness the distribution of over 400,000 copies of English, Mathematics and Science Book 3 and Book 6 and other assorted library books procured by UBEC headquarters from the provision of the instructional materials component of the UPE funds. The quantities are as follows. Maths Book 6, we have 86,120 copies. English Book 6, we have 84,187 copies. Science Book 6, we have 44,000 copies. Maths Book 3, we have 100,000 copies. English Book 3, we have 100,000 copies. And assorted library books, we have 36,500 copies. This will be distributed to all public schools in the state. Already, books 1, 2, 4, and 5 have since been procured and distributed. Our teachers no longer have an excuse of not preparing lesson notes or not having the right textbooks to use. We would like to appeal to our traditional rulers, our community leaders, and members of the school management committees to assist us monitor the utilization of these books. The books have also been customized to prevent them from being diverted to other places. But we would also use this opportunity to appeal to communities to be vigilant in case some people decide to divert the books. The education secretaries are also under instruction, sir, to organize training sessions for the teachers on how to use these textbooks. We have also requested UBEC headquarters and the publishers to organize similar trainings on the use of the books so that they are not just kept in the head teacher's cupboards. The Governor, sir, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we are delighted to report that the recent payment of additional counterpart funds of 1.7 billion by the state government to the UPE has boosted the rating of the state on the table of drawdown performance and placed Plateau State among the top performing states. The counterpart funds paid covers the period 2008, 2009, and 2010. The board is presently processing the implementation of the following: training of 6,000 teachers on reading and writing skills. 13,400 teachers would be trained on strengthening the teaching of mathematics and science. This will be done in partnership with the Japanese International Cooperation Agency. About 100 teachers are set for training at the National Mathematical Center starting next week. There's also going to be training of junior secondary school teachers on how to manage inclusive classrooms. That is classrooms where you have normal children and children with different forms of disabilities. We are also set to procure, to manufacture 92,324 pieces of furniture to furnish 4,616 classrooms. We are also going to embark on the renovation of 86 schools, construction of 524 new classrooms, construction of 44 VIP toilets, and then procurement of additional 288,420 textbooks and other instructional materials. Finally, sir, we in SUBEP would like to assure you that the emergency declared in the education sector is not misplaced, regardless of what critics would want the public to believe. What is being done in the education sector is akin to renovating a dilapidated structure. Some portions have to be excavated, some demolished, some chiseled out, some restructured, and some reconstructed. And that is just what we have been doing in the past 3.5 years. So much has been done, but because it is at the foundational level, not much seems visible yet. But we know that as long as God's hand is on this agenda, that by 2013, when the children that were in class one in 2007, when you became governor, move into the junior secondary school, the difference will be clearer than 7 up. Once again, on behalf of the board, management and staff, we appreciate your coming and wish you victory in the April 2011 polls. We declare that because you are a gift to Plateau State, that in this season, that you will finish strong. We also want to appreciate all our distinguished guests that have been here since about 12:30. We sincerely apologize for the delay, but as you know, this week has been a busy week for the governor. He has just risen from a stakeholders meeting, and we understand there's another meeting waiting for him to preside over. So we appreciate your coming, and we pray that you continue to give the governor and the government of Plateau State the necessary support. We also want to use this opportunity to extend our sincere appreciation to the principal and staff, including the students of the government technical school, for not only accepting to store our supplies, but also working tirelessly to ensure the successful hosting of this event. So we had to move our store to Kuru here because of security issues where we used to store our books. And we didn't want a situation where, in a twinkling of an eye, the books will be reduced to ashes. And the school here has been looking after the books very well. And this is what also informed us hosting the program jointly with the Mdgs, because we discovered that they also kept their materials here. And we feel that instead of calling the governor out twice, it is better to kill two birds with one stone. And that's why we decided to do a joint project. And we want to also inform you, sir, that because of what the technical school is doing to us, the board is exploring ways and means to enrich their school libraries with modern books in technical education. Because we believe that that would be useful to them. We want to sincerely thank everybody for coming. May God bless all of us. Thank you.
There, but for the context, for what so much, I mean, for the much that has been done by the Jan administration in the state, giving support to these agencies, and that's why we're here. I'd like to thank you.
The governor of Plateau State, Dr. Jonah David Jan, the Right Honorable Speaker, Plateau State House of Assembly, the Secretary to the State Government, the Chairman Subed, Honorable Commissioners, Chairman of Commissions, Permanent Secretaries, Local Government Chairman, Your Royal Highness, the Bonrei Kuru, and other royal fathers here present, elder statesmen here present, the principal and staff of this institution, members of various institutions here present, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to welcome the governor and his entourage and all of you to this very important and historic occasion that will usher in a new phase of development in Plateau State. Today is important because we at the Millennium Development Goals Project Support Unit are honored to have the governor for the first time to distribute these vital equipment to some of our public health centers in the state. It is no doubt a clear testimony that your untiring and unwavering commitment to the redemption of Plateau State and the physical transformation of both our urban and rural areas. The Mdgs Project Support Unit is in the state could not have been a reality were it not for your personal interest in exploring useful partnership with donor agencies to complement and expand the frontiers of intervention in the provision of needed infrastructure and services to our people. Indeed, a silent revolution has been going on through the MDGs in areas that are making the difference in our lives and in the lives of our people. The 8 Millennium Development Goals have come to represent the collective will and desire of governments and communities across the world to better the living conditions of their people. And Plateau State, under the able and focused leadership of Dr. Jonah David Jan, has marched steadily towards the attainment of these goals. I am optimistic that by 2015, all communities in Plateau State will have the basic needs enshrined in the goals. The history of MDGs in Nigeria is closely linked to the gains that were made from debt relief, which are being channeled to specific areas of development. The country came out with a strategy to utilize for the utilization of such funds known as the Conditional Grant Scheme, CGS, as a framework to guide the federal government and state governments in the planning, implementation, evaluation, and funding of projects. The CGS allows for 50-50 funding ratio for projects within a given fiscal year by state and federal government, and the successes recorded so far have been enormous and encouraging. In matching words with action, the Jan administration in the state approved released the sum of $1.3 billion as counterpart fund for the 2008-2009 programs. These have ushered in a period of massive intervention in the provision of basic human needs. Under the 2008 grants, 68 solar-powered boreholes were provided, and 17